Hello students, today we are discussing the Numpy, which has been included in your data handling part of your syllabus of IP, and we will see here how Numpy is useful in order to develop program and the data types. What is Numpy? The Numpy library is a popular Python library used for scientific computing applications and is an acronym for numerical Python. It is an open source module of Python that provides functions for first mathematical computation on arrays and matrices. In general, array refers to a named group of homogeneous elements, means same type of elements you can store in an array. Now see, what is an array? Array is a container type of things that can hold a fixed number of items, and all the items will be of same type. It is having two elements, that is element and index. Element means each item stored in an array is called an element, and index means the location, means from where the you will retrieve the particular data in an array, because array is a single reference. It is under single reference, several values can be stored in an array, which is also known as array subscript. This is the anatomy of array. You see out here there are three things: access, rank and shape. Access means how many axes are there, like we are having in mathematical graph, x-axis, y-axis, like that. Like single dimensional is having one axis only, and double dimensional is having axis 0 and 1, that means 2 axes, and 3D three-dimensional is having 3 axes as well, that is 0, 1 and 2. And the shape is actually defined by the number of elements it contains along each of its axes. Like if you are talking about a 2x3 array, that will contain 3 elements in each row. This is the representation of an array. You can see out here, this is the array, a length is of 10, index starts with 0, means it can contain 10 elements only. Each element can be accessed with its index, and the range of indices will be 0 to n minus 1 always. That means if there are 10 elements for the particular array, there will be valid index range will be 0 to 9. Indices are also known as subscript, previously also I have told you. So this is the thing. So the single reference has been divided into 10 different memory locations. Going to the multidimensional array, you can see out here how nicely the data has been mapped out here. Okay, so first subscript is 00 because row and column. Okay, and then 01, 02 as well. So there are total 3 into 4, 12 elements can be stored in this two-dimensional array. And here is a callout has been given for you, which is actually showing you the index. Okay, so the thing is that I think it is clear for you. So we are having the single dimensional array, 2D array and multidimensional array. Also multidimensional array means more than one row and one column, you can say that. All right, now we are coming out with the Numpy, how to work with the command to be used: import Numpy as np. You can change this np also. Okay, any set of letters can be given as identifier. Okay, this is actually also known as alias. Okay, so the first command has to be used, that is Numpy as np, import command to be used for that. All right, you can see the different types of array, and this is the 2D array and this is the 3D array. You can see here the array versus list. What is the difference between Numpy array and Python list has been shown out here. Numpy array works on homogeneous steps, but the list you can keep the heterogeneous steps. Heterogeneous means different type of data can be stored. It does not support addition and removal of elements, whereas list supports the removal and addition of elements, means you can edit out here. Numpy array has memory consumption is less, and it is having more memory consumption, faster runtime execution Numpy array. And Python list execution time is slower than the array. Now we will see how to create a Numpy array. That is, to create a one-dimensional or two-dimensional array in Numpy, different way. You can see the same program has been shown out here. All right, you can see how the array can be stored into different variables. Here it has been taken as L1 and it has been stored into L1 and into the error 1 variable, and here it is directly printed from error 1, and the array has been given directly out here. You can see a two-dimensional array also has been printed. Alright, a two-dimensional array, you see it is a 3x3 array has been printed, np.array. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 has been considered to be a single row element, the first row, second row and third row as well, you can see. And the column wise, if you talk about, then it is the 1, 5, 6 is the first column, 2, 6, 7, 2nd, 3, 7, 8 is the third, 4, 8, 9 is the fourth one. So now next we are moving to the next. To create a numpy array method from string, to create a one dimensional array from string in numpy, data np.formString 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, data type int, and you can see out here the separator has been given as a space, and the space has been output out here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see how to use the empty method. It is used to create empty or an uninitialized array of specified shape and data type. You can see here np.empty 33 data type is float has been given, and the printing has been done for this particular type. So this particular thing has been used to create the uninitialized array. Method 0. Identically, it works like an empty function, but the only difference is it creates and returns a new array with all zeros. You can see out here the two dimensional zero array and the 1D zero array. Okay. Now next is method of once. It works identically like empty function, but only the difference is it creates and returns a new array with all elements as one. You can see out here the array has been given. The method is np.once. A 2/3 array has been created and a 7 elements array has been created by the commands. You can see out there arrange. Arrange means to create an array from a range. Here the syntax has been shown: start, stop, step and data type. You can see out here error 1, error 2, all these things are there. Okay, and here you can see 3 to 9, that means 3 from 3 till 8 means one less will be created. And here also the same thing, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, that is np of float 32 bits and np of 32 bits has been taken. And down below you can see the start is 2, 3 and step is 0.1. Sometimes data type is optional, you may omit it also. Method line space. This function can be used to prepare array of range of any range. Np line space, start, stop and space means in between you are giving the starting point and the ending point, and in between how many spaces will be there, that can be shown easily. 1, 2, 3, 1 to 10, that means first one is 1 to 10 and then 10 spaces in between, and here it is been given 2, 3 and the 7 spaces between the float values, between the 2, 3. That's why the different float values have been created. All right that is the thing. Actually the Python has been the dynamic initialization type. Actually the dynamic things has been created out here. Fine. So dynamically it will be changed into floating point type. You can see out here method copy. This function used to create a copy of an existing array. To use the method reshape, this method is used to change the arrangement of items while maintaining the same number of items. Import numpy as np you can take as well, because this is the command that you have to use in order to call the numpy class and its related methods. And a equals to np.array, some elements have been stored out here, and np.reshape 2, 3, see out here. So it is 2, 3 means it will be changed into shape 2x3 array. All right it will be 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. Instead of this, it has been it was a single dimensional array, but it's taken the shape of 2×3 array. All right now you see out here to create the numpy array by the I and identity method. The I method can be stored to create an identity matrix, which can be very useful to perform a variety of operations using arrays. You can see out here the arrays, how it has been created. You can see out here, this is the output actually. and the output you see there is this there is a unique kind of array. All other elements are zero and the diagonal elements are only one. So that's why to create an identity matrix, this kind of matrix are called identity matrix, where the diagonal element is zero. And from here we can say that the array, numpy array methods have been discussed finally. So this is the end of part one. Try to understand these things and all. You can consult any book against this, and you can try out this particular program in Python as well. So till then, thank you. Be safe.